electron and then eject the electron. This is according to the classical physics, right? But from the experimental results, it will give the electron instantaneously. So this is against the concept of classical physics, okay? And at that time they cannot explain this. And the last one that is the most important one, the most important one is that the ejection of the electron is depend on the frequency. Okay, it means that no electron I emit if the incident light frequency fall below some cut-off frequency, whose value is characteristic of the material being illuminated. Okay, no electron I eject below this cut-off frequency regardless of the light intensity. This is very important. Regardless of the light intensity, it means that you can shine the very intense light to the surface of the metal. And from the definition of the intensity, you can see that if you give them enough time, I mean that if you shine the light for a long enough time, it should give the enough energy to the electron to escape or for the metal plate to eject the electron. But that is not the case. From the experiment, we don't see this. From the experiment, we will, if the frequency is less than some value that we call it the cutoff frequency, okay, there will be no electron eject from the metal plate. But if it the frequency is larger than this cutoff frequency, even the intensity is very low, you will get the electron from the metal plate. And that is what the classical physics cannot explain. And this is very important. Okay, this point is very important. Okay. This is also the consequence of the third result, that is the maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectrons increase with increasing light frequency. Okay, if you increase the if increase, if the frequency increase, you found that the stopping potential increase. The stopping potential increase, and when the stopping potential increase, it means that K max increase. Okay, so the maximum kinetic energy increase with the frequency, and that is not the classical physics predict. Okay, so we need the new theory to explain this. And the one that gives the explanation is Einstein. Einstein is the one who gives the explanation of this phenomena, and he expressed this relation, and this is one of the most famous equation in physics. That is, he said that he gives the concept of the photon. It's the concept of the photon. The photon is the quantum of energy. Say that the photon is a Einstein used the hypothesis of Planck, but he extended that hypothesis to the general case in the sense that Planck gave the hypothesis only for the back body radiation, but Einstein extended this hypothesis to every kind of wave, meaning that every kind of electromagnetic wave will have the discrete energy, and he called this quantum of energy of light, he called it a photon. Okay, he called it a photon. And he said that each photon will have the energy equal to hf. Okay, each photon has the energy equal to hf. And this equation, the meaning of this equation is that this is the energy from light photon. When it hit the metal plate, it will give this energy to electron. But electron need some energy to escape from the metal, from the surface of the metal. And the energy for to escape the surface, we call it the work function. Okay, the work function is the energy that electron need to escape the surface. Okay, so this is the work function, and this work function we use the symbol phi here. This equation means that the energy from the photon minus the energy that for the electron to escape from the plane is equal to the kinetic energy of the electron, right? This is the kinetic energy of the electron. Okay. So, from this equation, he can explain all experimental results. He can explain all experimental results. Okay. This equation tells us that the energy of the photon is equal to the summation of the kinetic energy of the electron plus the work function. Okay, so it comes from this equation. But the point is that the light transmits the energy in a discrete way. It's not transmit the energy continuously, but it transmits the energy in a discrete way. And we call the quantum of energy as the photon. So the point is that when the photon hit the electron, it will give all amount of energy to the electron. It's not like when we shine the light to the electron, and it will continuously give the energy to the electron. But if it is a photon, try to imagine that if you throw a ball and it hit something, it will give all energy in the ball to the object that it hit, right? So the energy transfer will happen instantaneously. From this concept, the energy transfer will happen instantaneously. And more from that is that the energy of the photon depends on the frequency. You can see that the energy of the photon depends on the frequency. So the maximum kinetic energy of the electron depends on the frequency also. There is no intensity in this equation. So the maximum kinetic energy is independent from the intensity, and that is agree with the experimental results. This table gives some data for the work function for the some metal. Okay. Now, this is what I am just describing. The equation for the energy of the photon, equation 40.9, show that the maximum kinetic energy is independent of the light intensity, right? This is independent of the light intensity. Okay. The maximum kinetic energy of any one electron is equal to the SF minus phi. Okay. Depend only on the light frequency. This is very important. This depend only on the light frequency. Okay. And the work function. The work function.The value of work function depend on the type of of the metal, right? But for the light, it depend on the frequency of the light only. If the light intensity is double, the number of photon alive per unit time is double.